The Omicron variant has been present in Europe even before the first cases were reported in South Africa. That's according to new data from the Netherlands. The new variant was found in two Dutch test samples from November 19 and 23. These were days before South Africa officially reported its first cases on November 25. Both cases in the Netherlands do not have a travel history. Scientists also found cases of the Omicron variant in Belgium and Germany prior to November 25. The new findings may underscore the futility of sweeping travel restrictions imposed on Southern Africa after it reported its first cases. The Omicron variant has spread in over a dozen countries and territories now. The latest cases were detected in Japan and Brazil. An expert from South Africa believes the Omicron variant could outcompete the Delta variant in terms of transmissibility. Here's the full story.
The Omicron coronavirus variant detected in Southern Africa could be the most likely candidate to displace the highly contagious Delta variant. That's according to Adrian Puren, the acting executive director of South Africa's National Institute of Communicable Diseases, or NICD. He spoke to Reuters on Tuesday.
We thought, well, what will outcompete Delta? I think that's always been the question. What will outcompete Delta in terms of transmissibility, at least?
The discovery of Omicron has caused global alarm, with countries limiting travel from Southern Africa for fear it could spread quickly, even in vaccinated populations, and the World Health Organization saying it carries a high risk of infection. If Omicron proves to be more transmissible than the Delta variant, it could lead to a sharp spike in infections that could put pressure on hospitals. Puren said scientists should know within 4 weeks to what extent Omicron can evade the immunity generated by vaccines or prior infection, and whether it leads to worse clinical symptoms than other variants. Anecdotal accounts by doctors who have treated South African COVID-19 patients say Omicron appears to be producing mild symptoms, including a dry cough, fever, and night sweats, but experts have cautioned against drawing firm conclusions. Puren said it was too early to say whether Omicron was displacing Delta in South Africa. Anne von Gottberg, a clinical microbiologist at the NICD, said it looked like infections were rising throughout the country, but cautioned against linking that with Omicron just yet.
In fact, and some of those admissions might have started before we think the emergence of Omicron, and we also seen that there was an increase in influenza cases in South Africa just in the last month or so. And so we need to really be careful to look at the other respiratory infections and other respiratory diseases.
We are deeply disappointed.
Leaders in South Africa have criticized swift travel restrictions by the United States and other nations as unfair and crippling to their tourism and other sectors. South Africa has reported close to 3 million COVID-19 infections during the pandemic and over 89,000 deaths, the most on the African continent.
Well, the Philippines again lands at the bottom of Bloomberg's COVID Resilience Index for the third straight month. The Philippines ranked last in a list of 53 countries based on indicators spanning from virus containment, restarting travel, and vaccination coverage. But Health Undersecretary Mirna Cabotaje says Bloomberg's data on Manila's vaccination may not be up to date. Government is currently on its third and last day of a massive inoculation campaign where it aims to vaccinate 9 million Filipinos.
It depends on the time comparison was made. Initially, we had very scarce resources. That is why we needed to prioritize certain geographic areas. Late October, November, our vaccines came in better numbers. We are anticipating that we will be able to reach the 9 million, but with a 2.5 million accomplishment on day one, we expect to equal or even surpass it yesterday. Our figures are not yet in. We were hoping more jabs would have been administered yesterday, it being a holiday and provided more opportunity for the vaccinees to go to the vaccination centers.
The UAE topped Bloomberg's COVID Resilience Index for November, saying life there has basically returned to normal, routing out the top five are Chile, Finland, Ireland, and Spain. On the flip side, Poland, Malaysia, Vietnam, and Indonesia joined the Philippines in the bottom five. Malacanang has repeatedly dismissed Bloomberg's resilience index as biased. New COVID cases in the Philippines fall to their lowest level this year. The country reported just 425 new infections Tuesday, the fourth straight day that the daily tally was below 1,000. Active cases also dropped to 15,000, the lowest since June of last year. Guido David, the Octa Research Group, notes average infections in the National Capital Region have decreased to around 200. He believes it's possible that figure could further slide by 100 by Christmas, but that will still depend on the possible effects of the new Omicron variant. The World Health Organization believes the Philippines doesn't need to reimpose its face shield policy yet, despite the threat of the Omicron variant. The WHO's representative to the Philippines says they are still looking into how the new variant is transmitted.
So I think it will be premature now to go there and say we need to reintroduce face shields, because we also know that there is significant public discontent on the mandatory use of face shields. So it's better to get public compliance with the measures that are there and take a risk-based approach to reanalyze whether we need to go into the use of face shields or not.
The WHO statement comes as the Philippines' COVID task force considers bringing back the mandatory use of face shields when indoors.
In closed settings, no? Sa closed settings kasi yung pinag-uusapan yung kung kailangan, no? But one thing is for sure, based on our latest IETF resolutions, employers and establishments may require face shields for the protection of customers. We'll have to look where this goes if magkakaroon ng Omicron.
An infectious diseases expert recommends Filipino children as young as 5 be vaccinated against COVID-19. Dr. Ronchin Solante says regulators should approve the vaccination of 5 to 11-year-olds if the Philippines is going to expand face-to-face classes amid the Omicron threat. He also supports the proposal to mandate vaccinations with a renewed threat of a variant-driven surge.
We need to review again the vaccines that are available that are permitted for 5 to 11 years old. We already approved the 12 to 17. I think we need to review. Are we going to give? Can we give the vaccines to the 5 to 11 years old? If you look at countries where this vaccine has been already approved, I think they are now into fast-tracking the vaccination, not only for adults, but also for children.